One of the things that can suck the life out of an otherwise good track is a robotic feel. Subtle variations in a repeating loop can change it from lifeless to organic. In this video, I'm going to suggest a few techniques to help you make a static synth loop sound a little more organic. I'm going to start us off with two tracks. First, a simple drum loop to serve as our foundation. Next, an even simpler synth chord riff to serve as a starting point for this lesson. Now please note, the tools I am using today, more specifically Logic Pro and Native Instruments Massive, are not required to implement the techniques I am going to demonstrate. In fact, you should be able to replicate these results with almost any digital audio workstation, including Ableton Live, Cubase, or Reason. Also, you'll need a synth plugin, but that can be of your choosing. Okay, back to the track. As I said, I'm starting with a very basic synth chord riff. This kind of riff is very common in most subgenres of electronic dance music. From deep house to trance, you can easily find examples of a repeated single chord stab serving as the melodic foundation of a track, but it can get boring and quick. I've purposely picked a sound that's very simple and dry, hardly any effects on it. You can add effects to the final results if you choose, but for now, it's easier to highlight the changes you'll make if they aren't clouded up by delays and reverbs. The next step is to create an exact duplicate of this track. Same plugin, same volume and pan settings, everything. I'm going to mute the original track and name this second track differently so I won't confuse the two. Now I'm going to open my synth plugin. Again, in this case, Native Instruments Massive. The goal of this next step is to edit a few parameters to create a subtly different version of the same sound. This step will be open to some interpretation by you. There are no rules as to how you can achieve this, so feel free to experiment, but I'll recommend some good candidates for change. For me, the first place I head is the fine tuning. Creating a slight detuning of each oscillator will create a warmer, wider feel once we combine it with the original sound. Remember, I'm talking about the fine-tuning, changes in sense, not semitones. Changing the semitone tuning can be an effective tool here as well, but I prefer to keep things simple and subtle. Next, I'll play with the waveforms or the pulse width of individual oscillators. Minor changes in these knobs can create a distinct yet related sound. Some of the things you won't see me change are the amplitude or filter envelopes. I want the sound to have the same kind of temporal characteristics. Again, there are no rules, so feel free to experiment with the envelopes, but I prefer our second sound to be different in tone rather than shape. So I think I've successfully created a similar yet distinct variation in the original sound. Let's see what happens when I play the two together. It's not bad. It sounds a little thicker, but maybe a little too full. I've just added to the sound, but I need to work on it more to get the effect I'm looking for. I'd like to separate the two by a bit of panning, one a little left and the other a little right. This will widen the sound a little and create a little bit of space in the middle of the stereo spectrum. How much you pan the sounds will be up to your personal taste, but I recommend smaller amounts. Now, as I listen to the riff, I realize I've managed to create a fuller sound, but I'm still looking to create more subtle variations. Most digital audio workstations today have some form of groove, swing, or shuffle control. I won't get into how those controls work or what they do. It would definitely take too long and is outside of the scope of this tutorial. But there's plenty of information to be found on the web if you'd like to learn more about it. I'm going to mute the second track, and then I'm going to head over to my quantizing groove controls for the first track. I'm going to select a very extreme setting, which will not sound good at first, and then I'm going to dial it back until I find a nice feel. Nothing too much, just a little extra push and pull to get some feeling into the riff. Once I've settled on the right feel, I'm going to repeat this step for the second track. However, I'm going to alter the percentage of the swing just a tiny bit. It's almost going to be imperceptible, but it will mean that some of the notes on the second track will not play exactly at the same times as their counterparts on the first track. Most people tend to use the same setting on their groove or swing controls across every track in their project, but that's kind of counterproductive in my opinion. While it may seem like you're creating more funk or groove to your track, in actuality, you're just substituting one kind of precise repetition for another. Think of the funkiest live band you've ever heard. While the overall feel might have an overall swing, you could be sure that each player in the band is swinging a little more or less. It's just not natural to have every note subdivision playing at the exact same time. Okay, back into it. We've now created two subtle variations to help the feel of our track. Let's create a third. I'm going to place Logic's auto filter on the first track. Most of you will have a similar plugin in your arsenal, and many times it will be included in your workstation software. The key here is going to be subtle modulations of the filter cutoff. I will set a low-pass filter almost completely open, and then adjust the modulation depth to a low value and the LFO or modulation rate to something very slow. I would encourage you not to use a synced value. That will just create a repeating effect, which is what we are trying to avoid. So you can hear and understand the effect, I'm going to turn up the modulation depth to full. Can you now hear how dramatic the change is? Obviously, that's too much for me, so I want to bring it back down to a level that will yield small, subtle results. Next, I'm going to copy this plugin, settings and all, to the second track. But with this one, I'm going to alter the speed just a tiny bit, and the modulation depth an even smaller amount. Why? Because while I want the same changes to the tone to take place, I do not want them to happen at exactly the same time. By changing the speed and depth, I've ensured that each of the two tracks will have different fluctuations in tone over time. Let's move on. Now we're going to humanize the MIDI regions. Again, this is a common feature in most audio software, so if you aren't sure how to do it, please consult your user manual or browse the many forums out there that are geared towards your specific software package. You could, of course, do everything that we are about to do here manually, but that might take some time. I'm going to select all of the MIDI regions in both tracks. Next, I'm going to open up Logic's humanize setting in its transform window. And then I'll adjust a few of the default settings. For the position setting, I'm going to keep this value very low. I want to see some randomization in the position, but anything more than a small change will just sound sloppy. Next, I'll work the velocity. This can be set a little higher. In most synths, velocity is used to modulate volume, and sometimes filter cutoff. Although in more complex synths like Massive, velocity can be used to modulate almost anything, but I'm trying to keep it simple. So I won't add any additional destinations to velocity. Lastly, note length. Again, tiny changes. I want each track to have a similar note length. All right, I'm going to apply these changes and take a listen. You can immediately hear the change. The riff has a way more organic feel. The changes in volume, note length, filter cutoff, and note position create a repeating phrase that still has variation in life. Lastly, to bond the sound together, I'm going to route them both to a bus track and apply some gentle compression. This will help glue the two sounds together. Also, I think I might put on a little bit of reverb, just a small ambient sound with the mix set very low. Again, this is going to help the sound feel like it's coming from the same space. It's not what I would call a huge change, but it's more compelling to the ear. It feels a little looser, more relaxed, but at the same time, fuller and more interesting. I would encourage you to experiment with this process. Add more variations, layer additional synths and different effects. As I said, there are no rules here, but with just a few quick tweaks, you can make your synth lines have a little more feeling. I hope you enjoyed this video. Until next time, I'm Mike Corrales.